Hi guys, what's good? So I finally get to see Avatar Last Airbender, the live action, and to be honest, it was amazing. And for the very first time, I am very grateful and thankful that I didn't listen to the reviews online and the whole people saying different things. Guys, in fact, I want you to promise me one thing. Before you make any critique or review of the movie, of the series, please just go and see it first. Do not listen to all these guys online saying a whole lot of, you know, whatever, different opinions. Now guys, let's look at the story. For me, I will give the story an 80/100. You know, the thing is, a whole lot of us are trying to match the Avatar series, the live action. We're trying to match it against the standard of the animation. To be honest, that is an impossible standard. We all know that the Avatar Last Airbender, Legend of Aang, the animation remains up there. It is an A level, it is super. We are acting like we didn't know that someone, I don't want to mention the name, tried to recreate it before in one movie like that, and it was not very great. And we get to see Netflix invest a whole lot of CGI, a whole lot of investment, a lot of effects, a lot of story, a whole lot of, characters, casts, even the whole choreography, you know, the action, the fight scenes, the combat scenes. It was beautiful. So it is important that if you are going to see this series, please go with an open mind. Do not go with the expectations that you wanted it to be like what you experienced it maybe like when it was released in 2005, when you were a kid. No, guys, please don't do that. Now, let's look at the story. You know, when I opened the Netflix and wanted to experience it, I was not expecting too much, to be honest. But to be honest, it blew me beyond imagination. Now, let's look at the story. The story, of course, unfolded in a very beautiful way, you know, giving us Aang's beginning, you know, when he was found in the iceberg and the rest of it like that. I don't want to include spoilers anyway. But I love the fact that the characters in this story do not have to try so hard to be like what they have. You know, trying too badly. You know, when an actor is trying too badly to fit to the script, it feels so unreal, it feels forced. So I'm glad that the characters try to give their own interpretation of, you know, the story without leaving the original, you know, without actually moving away from the source material. But you could feel that the story was alive. People forget that when you are reimagining a movie or a source material from animation to the cinema or to TV or for a TV show, you have to recreate this in a way that the viewers get to experience it without you picking it word for word and letter for letter. So for the guys here, I'm going to give them a huge props for what they did to the story. I think they rewrote the story in such a way by, if you're a big fan of Avatar Last Airbender, you would know that from episode one, you could feel, you know, the whole Aang interpretation coming in, you know, his interference with the spirit world, his interaction with the spirit world, finding Katara, discovering, you know, the interaction with Sokka, even some flashbacks that takes him back to, you know, his time with the in the Southern Air Temple with his fellow monks, with Gyatso, his best friend. Even when he was told that he was going to be the Avatar, you could see, you could experience it. And I loved how they tried to weave these things as flashbacks, giving the viewers a wholesome experience. You know, I don't blame people who want to talk down on the series, but to be honest, what I experienced blew my mind. Because I'm sounding this way because I have seen a movie. We all know the Avatar movie by Shyamalan, but let's not pretend that we don't know. And a whole lot of us were not happy with the Avatar because we felt like it was a whole departure from the original source material. It didn't even try. But these guys made a very beautiful attempt. Look at the bending effects. Water bending. See, I don't know how much Netflix cut out as budget for this series, but wow. And I also love the fact that they didn't try to whitewash you know, the series with the characters. They try their best with the cast, try to, you know, add some bits of cultural diversity. Because I mean, if we are talking about the kingdoms, we all know that Avatar's universe seems to have more of the Asiatic and the Buddhist kind of feel to it. So I love the fact that they pick these guys from different cultures and try to blend them and give us a better reimagination of the series. So for me, the story, for episode one, the story started so well, started with the background. If you're a follower, if you are an enthusiast of the Avatar Aang series, from the animation, from the original animation in 2005, you could even see, I also like the fact that even the Aang that was chosen, the guy could act. These are kids, and they may not be A-list actors, but come on, extend some grace to them. They did a very good job. The acrobatics, the combat scenes. I'm talking about a story because I feel like the story was refreshing. You know, I get to see the spirit world, how they reimagine it when Aang wants to get into the spirit realm and, you know, interact with other avatars. Oh my goodness, I love, you know, I was happy when I saw Avatar Roku. I saw Kiyoshi. Oh my goodness. I saw Avatar Kuku or Kuru? I've forgotten his name. Even the bear, the spirit bear that was, you know, ravaging forests in one of the animations, still came alive in this live action. Beautiful, guys. Beautiful. Come on, you guys should see. And Fire Lord Uzai, my goodness. When I experienced Fire Lord Uzai, I was like, Jesus. And I have to give it to the guy who played Zuko. The Zuko character really, really tried his best. Wow. You see, I love the rage he brought into it. And he brought the rage in such a way without trying to forcefully become the Zuko of the animation. We all know Zuko from the very beginning was very crazy about looking for the Avatar, finding the Avatar. But it is beautiful to see this Zuko bring his own kind of rage. I love it. And yes, the very sweet Uncle Iroh was also someone I really loved. You know, the whole, his wisdom, his quotes, while also being the ferocious dragon of the West. So, to be honest, I'm going to give it a 90 over 100, the story. Now, let's talk about the cast. The choice in the cast, for me, I really think the casting, they did a very good job, which is very, very important. A whole lot of people might expect Sokka to be overly funny, but you don't know that even the animation Sokka had to be natural. He wasn't natural. I also think this Sokka here is lovable. I agree to love and appreciate him without trying to be forcefully be our beloved Sokka from the animation. The guy who gave it his interpretation did so well. Katara, of course, calm, serene, presence around her that was nurturing, yes. And I loved how they built their, at some point, the character, you know, the chemistry between these characters, you see how they evolve gradually and you become comfortable with them, you become comfortable with the cast. So yes, big ups to them, big ups to the choice, the costume, the design, the set, the back, everything. Even designing Appa, the flying bison, the flying limo, Momo, all these elements, they paid so much. For people who are talking down on this series, I don't know what they want. But if you expect that these guys will wake up one day and try to give you, and try to vomit what they gave you in 2005, the animation, I think it's unfair, because it won't even be interesting if you expect them to just pull out the source material and give it to you. And that's some little, you know, they have to rewrite this thing for the screen. As an adult, I saw the Avatar animation way back when I was probably 11 or 12. And looking at what it did today, it's still very much interesting. I still want to follow up. I still want to follow up with the maturity of the retelling of the story. You know, the spirit world. I love that part of it. When, I don't even want to, don't let me spoil you guys. Let's go to another thing here. For the cast, like I am saying, I think the cast, they did a very good job. They didn't try to whitewash. The cast guys, of course, you could tell that they had Asian heritage. They paid attention so much to things like Aang's meditation state, Aang's tattoos, his monk attire, Katara Water Tribe, you know, they looking like these guys from the Arctic, the Water Tribe guys looking. I love everything, the icy feel that he gave them. The costume was beautiful. For the Fire Nation, Jesus, the Fire Nation still brought out that kind of that beautiful elitist thing about them. The Fire Nation, that costume. And one person, even though they didn't give her enough time on the screen, but it was so amazing, it was Azula. Azula's character and the actress or the actor that played her did so well. And guys, if you really want to see Azula in action, the lighting, is it lightning bending? Azula tried that in the series, and you guys should just really open your mind to some of the beautiful things that came around in this series. Please go with an open mind. And some of the themes, yes, so it's 8 episodes. I really hope they do more, and I hope they don't just cut it down here, because I really hope people will watch the series a whole lot. If I'm comparing this with the source material, I'm going to say that these guys have created something beautiful from the source material. It doesn't necessarily have to be 100. In terms of accuracy, I'm going to give it 80. 80% of accuracy, because they are building, they're trying to build interest and appeal. So if they're copying it one by one, the appeal you had then as a child watching the Avatar, Legend of Aang, you can't, for you to sustain, people have a shorter attention span these days. So I love how they try to rewrite it, do some flashbacks, connect some dots here and there, and give you better imagination. Because if they did exactly and copied and lifted exactly how it was in the animation, I wouldn't have loved it. So I love the fact that they give some original feel. Even the cast gave their own original feeling to it. The set design was also very beautiful. I love the fact that, the attention to, the attention they gave to the design of the naval ship. The Fire Nation Navy was beautiful. King Bumi, also from the Earth Nation, Umarshu was also very beautiful. I saw the design of costume. Bending, the bending effect is also something we should actually applaud. The bending effect was something I know, is it M. Night Shyamalan or whatever, tried to do in the previous movie. I know he had issues with some CGI or some special effects, but I think these guys got it right. They got it way right, from bending of water to fire, energy, lightning bending, air bending. I also know that some people, there were some critics. I saw some reviews of the movie, and some people were expecting Aang to just be entering the Avatar state anyhow. They wanted to see him in the Avatar state. I'm like, guys, if you paid attention to even the original material, you would know that Aang took time. He took time to whine so much about his failure as the Avatar. He took so much time to be sorry for leaving the world and hiding. He took so much time. He even got. You guys should go and watch the source material and see that this guy really did a good job. But trying to say that, hey, come on, man, you expect him to just be going into the Avatar state like a car door every time, every now and then? No. This had to be built. Even when he was in the Southern Water Tribe, I think, and he had to bond with the fish spirit, the ocean spirit, to destroy the Fire Nation Navy. That was beautiful. These things are very accurate. I don't see any inaccuracy, but I just feel that they reimagined some concepts from the original material for better appeal, and I love it. I really love it. What else again am I missing out here? I'm going to say, in terms of comparison and accuracy, they did so well. So, ladies and gentlemen, I think you should actually go and see the series. Do not watch any review just yet. Go and see the series. Give yourself an open mind and go with the. These days, some people just really want to see movies for series, for feedback reasons, for criticism sake, for review sake. Let's go back to the era where we are enjoying cinematic pieces and TV pieces because we really want to enjoy them. These days, everybody just wants to. The internet culture drives feedback easily. But sometimes let's make the feedback worth it. If you're going to be seeing this series, please go and see it and enjoy it first. Right from the very beginning, go with an open mind. Do not go with the expectation that you want it to be it 100% vomits of, you know, the original source material. Allow yourself to appreciate the creativity and the imagination of the screenwriters. I think they did so well. They cast it so well. Of course, if you guys do so, if you guys give them a proper, honest feedback, I'm sure they're probably going to renew this season, because I really wanted to renew this season because I want to see Fire Lord Uzai. He's one of my favorites, and I love his interpretation. Thank you, guys. Please hit the subscribe button, like, and share. And let me know what you think if you've seen it as well. Cheers.
With my friends.